Hi students, welcome to the chemistry virtual lab. Today we are going to do the estimation of chloride content in the water sample by Mohr's method. Okay, I am Dr. S. Rekha, associate professor, RMD engineering college, Chennai. So let us get into the titration part. What is the principle behind it? Chloride ion in the form of NaCl, KCl, calcium chloride, magnesium chloride, etc. may be present in water sample and which need to be estimated by either by argentometric method or by Mohr's method. Okay, so argentometric is nothing but using silver nitrate solution, and Mohr's method is also, if we use silver nitrate solution for estimation of chloride, then we call it as Mohr's method. The reaction between chloride and silver is given below. So AgNO3 plus chloride ion present in water react together to form AgCl, which is a white precipitate. So we can remove the chloride ion by forming silver chloride precipitate, and sodium nitrate is formed. Another compound is sodium nitrate. So this white precipitate, on completion of the process, we cannot observe the change because white precipitate is there in the conical flask, and when it get over, it is difficult to identify. So what we do, we add indicator, we add potassium chromate as indicator. A small pinch of potassium chromate is added as an indicator. So now, after all NaCl is reacted with silver nitrate to form AgCl, AgNO3 reacts with potassium chromate to form silver chromate, which is reddish brown in color. So the end point will be the formation of reddish brown tinge. Once all the chloride ion is utilized, silver nitrate will react to form silver chromate. So in this white precipitate, this reddish brown tinge, okay, if you get, then that is the end point. If you continue titrating it, more and more amount of silver chromate will be formed. So it will turn out to be a dark reddish brown in color, and that is not the end point. Just to identify the end point, one or two molecules of chromate should react with silver nitrate. So that color you will get it as reddish brown tinge. Okay, so that is your end point. Let us see the simple procedure. Burette solution for titration 1 is silver nitrate solution. Pipette solution is 10 ml of standard NaCl solution. Indicator, 1 ml of 1% potassium chromate solution. Endpoint, color changes from yellow to reddish brown tinge. Then silver nitrate consumed, let it be V1 ml. Titration 2. Again, burette solution is silver nitrate solution. Pipette solution is 10 ml of sample water. Indicator is 1 ml of 1% potassium chromate solution. Endpoint is color changes from yellow to reddish brown tinge. Remember, then AgNO3 consumed in titration 2, let it be V2 ml. And the equivalent weight of chloride ion is 35.46. Chemicals required: sample water, standard NaCl solution, silver nitrate solution, 1% potassium chromate indicator. Apparatus required: conical flask, pipette, burette, and wash bottle. Now, fill up the burette with AgNO3 solution. So fill the nozzle and adjust to zero mark without the. Let us do titration 1. Pipette out 10 ml of NaCl solution into the conical flask. Upon add, let us add the indicator. So indicator is 1 ml of potassium chromate indicator. So on adding that, it turns to yellow in color.
Let us do the titration. So we have taken burette with the solution and we are going to titrate now. Upon titration, color changes to reddish brown tinge. So that is your endpoint. The endpoint is color changes from yellow to reddish brown tinge. So here you can see initially the solution is yellow, clear yellow. Then you have silver chloride precipitate, then it turns to reddish brown tinge. Now let us note down the AgNO3 consumed as V1 ml. And let us get the simulated reading by clicking the simulate button. Yes, students get ready to note down the values. So volume of AgNO3 V1 is 9.6 ml. So it is common to all students, because we have given same AgNO3 to all the students. Okay. So let us enter the value for titration 1 as shown in the tabular column. Okay. So you have to do for concordancy. So we will enter the value 2 times and we will record like this. Summary of the titration 1. So we have taken NaCl solution. To that we have added potassium chromate indicator and it turns yellow in color. Then upon titration it turns reddish brown orange in color. Okay, that is reddish brown tinge. Let us do second titration.
So pipette out 10 ml of sample water. Add to the conical flask.
Let us do titration 2. Burette filled with AgNO3 is titrated with the sample water with the indicator. So upon titration, it changes to reddish brown tinge. Yes. So endpoint is color changes from yellow to reddish brown tinge. So let us note down the AgNO3 consumed as V2 ml. And we have sample 5 sample water. So let us simulate and get the 5 sample waters. Okay. So batch 1 students. So your endpoint on simulation is 6.4 ml. Okay. Please make a note. Sample A 6.4 ml. So batch 2 students. Upon simulation you have got a value V2 as 7.1 ml. Okay. V2 as 7.1 ml. Batch 3 students, upon simulation, we have got a value V2 as 7.5 ml. Sample C, please note down. Sample C, V2 is 7.5 ml. Batch 4 students on simulation, we have got sample D as 6.8 ml. Okay. Now let us simulate last time for sample E. Yeah. Batch 5 students, sample E, endpoint is V2, which is 6.9 ml. Please make a note. So, let us summarize titration 2. So, what we did, we took water sample along with that. We have added potassium chromate indicator. So, upon adding that, we got yellow solution. Then, upon titrating with AgNO3, we got reddish brown color. Okay. Now, enter the value as shown in the tabular column.
Let us see the calculation. Titration 1, standardization of silver nitrate solution. So, volume of standard NaCl solution which we have taken is 10 ml. And strength of NaCl which is given in the question. Otherwise, ask your teacher. It is 0.01 normal. Volume of AgNO3. V2, which is what you get in the titer value. So that is your value. So here we have taken 12 ml and strength of AgNO3 is V1 N1 by V2 N2. So it is around 0.0083 for this 12 ml. Okay, the value could be different. For our case, simulated value was different, so you will get a different value. Titration 2 is the estimation of chloride ion. So volume of AgNO3 is V3 ml, which is 7.5 ml we have taken. So for different sample this value is different, so calculate according to your value. Strength of AgNO3 N3 is the value which we got it from titration 1, it is 0.01042 normal. Volume of water sample taken, which is 10 ml. Strength of water sample, which is given as V3 N3 by V4, upon calculation we get 0.062. Okay. Amount of chloride ion present in 1 liter of the given water sample is nothing but equivalent weight into normality into 1000. 1000 is a multiplication factor for converting gram into milligram. Okay, so 0.0062 is the normality and the equivalent weight is 35.46 into 1000. So upon calculation we get 221 milligram per liter. So the amount of chloride ion present in water sample is 221 milligram per liter. Permissible limit is 250 milligram per liter. So this water sample is under the permissible limit.
Thank you, students. Hope so you have understood the experiment very well. Let us meet on another experiment. Thank you.